Now hey guys, welcome back to the channel and another Swiss 001 video. Now today we are, we are in Switzerland in the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Yes, we are on board a Citation CJ4, but that doesn't really matter. What does really matter actually is what is right ahead of us. Yes, we are flying above Lake Geneva, and as you can see down here, we have an aerobatic course on the water. Yeah, actually you can download this aerobatic course. This is an add-on, and actually this is one of the first add-ons I've installed for this flight simulator, and well, what can I say? It adds some pylons to Lake Geneva so that we can have some aerobatic action going on. Now, maybe the Cessna Citation CJ4 that we're in right now is not the proper plane for this one. I mean, we can try it right now. All the way, come on. Oh, this didn't work out at all, did it? Okay, yeah, maybe we have to go for a little bit of a smaller plane, I guess. I mean, you know, you always use propeller planes here on courses like this. A plane that I do know very well to fly is probably the Cirrus SR-22. I mean, I fly a Cirrus in real life, and this is like the 20th time me mentioning this. But yeah, I think I know how to fly this plane quite well, so maybe our chances with this one are looking a little bit better, I guess, especially compared to the CJ. Alright, I mean, yeah, well, when I think about it, the Cirrus planes are definitely no acrobatic aircraft. I mean, it after all is very much more responsive than something like the private jet that we were just in. But this thing cannot even pull loops or anything. You don't even want to do like a barrel roll. This is going to be very interesting. Let's just stay in this outside perspective for now and see how well that works. If that doesn't work, then we're going to have to go to the cockpit. So, I mean, let's just jump right in. Let's just join right here and we have to turn left immediately. And actually, that's going to be quite a sharp turn, isn't it? Okay, first pylon. Second one. Oh my goodness. Oh, alright. Alright. Oh no, we cannot do this thing. Alright. There we go. Pass through. Oh Jesus, water. Oh. I mean, to be fair, we did come quite far, didn't we? This is actually working quite a lot better than I thought.
Oh no. Oh.
Oh, alright, again, we have to skip this part here because I'm obviously terrified of it. But no, actually, the Cirrus SR-22 definitely cannot do the maneuver, whatever it actually is called here. We're gonna have to actually skip that. We're gonna continue with this race here. Come on. Oh, white. No, that was a crash. Alright, we didn't make this one. Alright, but we're still flying. Let's just fly through these pylons for now. Alright, so there's SR-22, is still going.
Oh.
Alright, now. Oh, sharp turn. That was actually quite nice, wasn't it? And there we go. I think I'm actually pretty good at this.
Oh no.
Okay, never mind. Alright, come on, let's just complete this course. Oh, we're super fast.
Oh,
another crash. Yeah, okay, maybe this plane is, it does work a lot better than I thought, but no, this doesn't work that well. Let's maybe try another plane that is more suitable for acrobatic flight. We'll come aboard the Aviat Pits Special. Very interesting plane. I mean, again, this is an acrobatic one. So now we finally have got a proper plane. We have a proper acrobatic course track, but we don't really have a proper pilot. No, honestly, I've never really been interested in acrobatic flight. Because, like, you know, I cannot even fly a plane properly the normal way. So, yeah, let's just see how well I can do here. Alright, let me just show you what this plane can do compared to especially the Cirrus as well. You know, for example, the aileron roll, no problem at all. Oh, Jesus Christ. Or maybe a loop, let's just do that real quick as well. Alright, that was not a nice loop. Yeah, see, I'm flying this plane for the first time, so... Alright, come on. Let's do this. Alright, we're looking good, we're looking good. Some more pylons, let's do this maneuver. Oh, yeah, I'm probably gonna keep skipping these parts here, because I don't have enough patience to actually learn how to fly this maneuver here, but whatever. Let's just go ahead and join back in. There we go. Now the left turn. That was quite close to hitting the pylon. There we go. Now the right turn. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, now we're back on track. Oh! Oh, what was that? There we go. Now a sharp right turn again. So let me go to cockpit view and see how that feels like. Oh, Jesus, you cannot see anything in here. Yeah, obviously the high wing is definitely blocking a lot of the stuff that's going on. Oh! Now we have got a very, very long, just straight part. And it looks like we are going to complete this course very, very soon. Let's just fly very close to the water. I want to do that as well sometime. There we go. We can see the reflection. That was really nice. Now, left turn again. We've actually completed this course. Now we've crashed. All right. I mean, we had zero deaths, only one try, of course. This was a very successful flight. Let's maybe try another plane. I mean, I want to try a prop as well, maybe. There we go. We got the TBM-930. Not a super small plane, so this is going to be interesting. All right, we'll come aboard the TBM. Oh, yeah, this is definitely not going to work out. But, I mean, we can give it a try, so let's just do that. All right, there we go. We are coming in quite nicely. Let's just see how well I can handle this. Sharp turn. Oh, goodness. I mean, we didn't crash. That's a good thing. All right, another very much sharp turn. Yeah, no way this is going to work out, is it? All right, there we go. Now, right turn and dead. All right, come on. Okay, we are very much fast, actually. Yeah, there's no way we can make this turn here. I mean, we can try some other acrobatic maneuvers in planes here in the flight simulator while we're at it. I mean, the parkour is not the best idea, but how about an aileron roll? Okay, never mind. That was a spiral to very much crash. But we can go up again, because we're in the flight simulator, so it doesn't really matter what happens, right? There we go. All right, now, let's just go ahead and pull up. Come in for a loop. That is maybe an easier thing to do. Come on, we're looking good. We're probably breaking all the avionics on board because the instruments, they obviously were not built for acrobatic maneuvers. And there we go, actually. The TBM, it is loop approved. Again, we might have broken the whole avionics, which may be a damage of several hundred thousand dollars, maybe even a million, actually. But that was okay. Let's just do this again. Boom, pulling all the way up. I don't know if this is actually realistic G-forces-wise, because we're forcing, obviously, a lot of Gs right now. I don't think you could actually do that in the real TBM. Let's just do this again. Oh, my goodness. I don't know. Is this realistic? I cannot tell. There we go. We're, again, just another round. That was perfect. And while we're at it, let's just try the aileron roll again. There we go. This actually worked as well. No problem at all. The TBM is definitely acrobatic approved. I mean, at least in the Microsoft Flight Simulator. Oh, my goodness. Oh, a plane that I would like to try out as well with the Icon A5. This is a very interesting plane. It's also a car, kind of. Yeah, I mean, it's not really a flying car, but it has a car interior, as you can tell. This is actually the only seaplane that is included in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. And, you know, we're above a lake, so this kind of fits quite well, doesn't it? I just put the gear back in. Actually, this plane is very much responsive as well. It's not that much of an acrobatic plane, though, so this is going to be interesting. Something that I don't really like about the Icon A5, though, definitely is the speed that it has, or perhaps doesn't have. At the top speed of this one is around 100 knots. Some people might even say that this plane oftentimes can get bird strikes from behind, you know, the birds are faster. So this is actually looking quite good, you know. This slow speed, it does help quite a bit here in this course. Doesn't really help with the times, because this, after all, it's a racing track, but it does help with completing the course in the first place, right? There we go. So far, we haven't crashed. There we go, looking good. Oh! We're just gonna ignore that. Alright. This, like, genuinely is not easy, but, you know, this is actually working. There we go. Actually, this plane is way better at performing aerobatic races than I thought. There we go, we're looking good. Oh! Alright. And now we have this very straight bit. While we're at it, let's actually try touching down on the water as well. Because again, this is a seaplane. There we go. That's quite nice. Something I do really miss here in this flight simulator is particles, by the way, especially when you touch down on water, either intentionally or unintentionally. We don't have particles at all here in this flight simulator, which does suck. Alright, let's stay a little low to the ground, maybe. That might be fun. There we go. This plane, it handles very, very well. Alright, so I think I'm a pretty good aerobatic pilot, am I not? So yeah, guys, thank you for watching today's video. And I'll see you tomorrow, as always. Good night.